Well, it's 5:20. I think we can start streaming now.
Okay.
Jai Jai Hai Bhagavati Sur
Bhairavi.
Jai Jai Hai Bhagavati Sur Bhairavi. Thank you.
Excellency, Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaya Naidu. Thank you so much, sir, for gracing us with your presence this evening. It is always wonderful to share the space with a man of your stature. My namaskarams to you, sir. Mr. Sheila Rajendra, the Dean and Director and Correspondent of PSBB Group of Schools. Mr. P.B. Balaji, the President of Parent Teacher Association and a proud alumnus, of course, of PSBB, parents, teachers of every branch of PSBB, and of course, students who have tuned in to this live broadcast on YouTube. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to Dr. YGP Memorial Day. It is, of course, a day of celebration, a day to celebrate the life and times of the doyen that is Dr. Mrs. YGP. Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. My name is Radhakrishnan Srinivasan, and I've walked the corridors in the late 80s and the early 90s of Padma Seshadri Balabhavan. And if there is one thing that I look back with tremendous amount of love, it is the sense of pride that has been inculcated in me. And as any other PSBBN, young and old, I look back at that time with pride, proud of who I am and proud of the values that I represent. Open your arms to change, but don't let go of your values, as someone has often said. I think when you look back at the life and times of Dr. Mrs. YGP, it rings so very true. Started around 1957-58 with a handful of students, 13 to be precise, to establish an empire of this magnitude is a stupendous task, curated carefully over 6 decades. At the same time, if there is one thing that she always wanted us to adhere to, it is the fact that she did not want us to bear the tag of RNIs, as in resident non-Indians. And therefore, she always was insistent on instilling a sense of Indianness, a sense of culture, a sense of identity and heritage into each one of us. I think when you walk through each and every campus of Padma Seshadri Balabhavan, it's fairly evident that these things hold so very true. At the same time, she also inculcated the belief, or rather she was firmly of the belief, that you always look around yourself to pick up the very best that the world has got to offer you and imbibe the very best from there and blend it with your own sense of culture and identity. And I think it is this sense of Indianness that we wear with tremendous amount of pride that she will be happy about. And wherever she is watching this event from this August evening, I'm sure she will be smiling as well. And it is that sense of culture and heritage and Indianness that we are about to celebrate, because the superwoman, the icon, and the legend in Dr. Mrs. YGP ensured that we have all these qualities. May I kindly request Mr. Sheila Rajendra, the Dean and Director and Correspondent, PSBB Group of Schools, to formally welcome the virtual gathering. Over to you, ma'am.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha, Yendaro Mahanubhavuluku, Andariki Vandanamulu. There are many great people here. To all of them, my namaskarams. I extend a very warm and hearty welcome to our Honorable Vice President, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu. It is truly an honor to have him with us today. 366 days have flown by since the iconic legend of education, Srimati Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi, fondly known as Mrs. YGP, attained Acharyan Thiruvidi. Memories are tangible threads that strengthen the bond in any relationship. This one such thread is being woven as a tribute to our Kula Guru and the beloved founder of the Padma Seshadri Balabhavan Group of Schools. We have assembled on this digital platform to celebrate the life of this spirited and dynamic educationist, administrator, and patron of the arts, and listen to the first memorial lecture in her honor. On behalf of the group of Padma Seshadri Balabhavan Group of Schools, it is my solemn duty to roll out a verbal red carpet to the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Ji, with folded hands, a bouquet of reverence, and profound gratitude. I extend a cordial welcome to you, sir. My sincere pranams, suswagatam. I extend a warm welcome to all our distinguished guests, trustees, and our dear alumni spread across the globe. I also extend an endearing welcome to our teachers, students, and parents, who together form the three arms of the Golden Triangle. A warm welcome to all the heads of schools and our well-wishers who have provided unflinching support to this 62-year-old institution. I accord a warm welcome to the press and media who have honored our invitation by joining us on this digital platform, and to TCS executives and their team of technical experts who are facilitating the digital medium. A couple of years ago, I had the good fortune of meeting the Honorable Vice President when I accompanied Dr. Mrs. YGP for the Vayo Shrestha Samman Award ceremony. She received this award from the Honorable Vice President himself. It is befitting that an astute leader of his stature has consented to deliver the lecture in memory of Dr. Mrs. YGP, whose mantra was AIR, accountability, integrity, responsibility. And she breathed this AIR all her life. Mr. Naidu Garu's noble philosophy in simple thinking, simple living, and high thinking, Dr. Mrs. YGP believed in the same and lived that life. A guest of such eminence needs no introduction, but for the benefit of young and impressionable minds watching this telecast, it would be worth the while and inspire them too. Mr. Naidu hails from a small village in Nelluru. Despite being a law graduate as a son of a farmer, he continues to be an agriculturalist by heart. This is because he believes, in his own words, that the basic culture of India is agriculture. Seeds of his future path were sown when he started his journey as a student who painted walls and set up loudspeakers for his leaders at public rallies. It is truly humbling to note that from the position of President of the Students' Union and Vice President of the BJP Youth Wing, Sri Naiduji, having spent much of his life relentlessly pursuing the causes of people and became a strong voice for their struggles, has risen to the exalted position of Vice President of India in August 2017. He holds this position with such dignity. I see a parallel between the two great persons, Mrs. YGP's and Naidu Garu's lives. Both started their journeys in thatched roofs, both fought tooth and nail to bring tangible change in the lives of future generations of this country. And both eventually ended up donning the roles of strict disciplinarians, while Mrs. YGP's role was limited to disciplining students in the school's quadrangle. Mr. Naiduji's fulfills that role with aplomb in the chambers of parliament. It is with pleasure we note that he has addressed several August gatherings all over the world. His visit to Chicago in September 2018 to mark the 125th anniversary of Swami Vivekananda's historic speech needs special mention. Mr. Naidu's speeches have been published as a book, Moving On, Moving Forward, and Listening, Learning, and Leading are the two other books that chronicles his role as a Vice President of India. Eloquence is the poetry of prose, goes a quote. Our Honorable Vice President is a powerful orator in both Telugu and English. He is loved for his witty quips, wordplays, and acronyms, his inimitable style of extempore speaking, and his interesting interplay of words and letters to effectively convey his message is enjoyed and cherished by all. With your indulgence, sir, I am going to take the liberty of emulating your style. Your combination of ability, credibility, and humility make you a nationally acclaimed, intelligent, dynamic Uparashtrapati. Naidu, Naiduji. We will all seek to translate your vision of a nation that aspires internationally, domestically, universally, Naidu, Naiduji, into reality. We at PSBB are indeed privileged and honored to have His Excellency, the Vice President of India, deliver the inaugural Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi Memorial Lecture. I take this moment to present the Honorable Vice President with a memento, a Tanjore painting of Lord Dhanvantri. Wishing you and your family a very good health and long life. I invite His Excellency, Mr. Venkaiah Naidu, to deliver the memorial lecture and bless us and our initiatives. Thank you.
எல்லோருக்கும் வணக்கம். மறைந்த டாக்டர் திருமதி ராஜலட்சுமி பாரசாரதி அவர்களின் முதல் புண்ணியத்திற்கும் எனது வணக்கங்களும் மரியாதைகளும். ஸ்ரீமதி ஷீலா ராஜேந்திரா, டீன் அண்ட் டைரக்டர் பத்மா சேஷாத்ரி பால் பவன் குரூப் ஆஃப் ஸ்கூல்ஸ், ஸ்ரீ பி பி பாலாஜி and other friends, and the coordinator of the program, Mr. Radhakrishnan, parents, teachers, and my dear young students. I can imagine the amount of dedication and commitment with which Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi built an institution like Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan Group of Schools. It is in the work of people like Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi lies the future of India, which once was known as Vishwa Guru and now again is striving to regain its lost glory in many spheres, including education. I felt very happy to know that Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan Group of Schools imparts value-based education. It was founded to revive and promote the spirit of Indianness, the spirit that celebrates national identity, cultural heritage, and social diversity. Our ancient values teach us share and care. I always say share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. And Vasudhaika Kutumbakam, Yutopadesha says, Vidyadadati Vinayam, Vinayadhyati Patratam, Patratva, Patratva, Dhanamopnati, Dhanad Dharmam, Tata Sukham. Dotted with institutes of repute such as Nalanda, Takshasila, Vikramasila, and Pushpagiri, ancient India was a storehouse of knowledge and wisdom. Our students must be aware of their civilizational inheritance and learn to combine the best of Indian and global practices. We should be proud of our culture, heritage, history, and our forefathers. Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parasarathi used to promote our culture and value system through Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan schools. That's the reason for my admiration for her work. My granddaughter also studied in the same school for a while. Of course, she lives in Chennai now. There is a lot of demand for admission to Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan schools. That speaks of the standards that are maintained by the school and its management. I'm happy to know that Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parasarathi used to ask her school students to greet teachers by saying Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha instead of the normal salutation. Namaskar is our samskar. This should show her deepest commitment to our culture, old Guru Shishya Parampara, which is unmatched by any other system in this world. In transmitting the best of Indian ethos, I'm told that she taught the students the Puranic lore of Ramayana and Mahabharata with stories that captured the time-honored traditions of reverence, sacrifice, nationalism, and simplicity. Everyone must note that the Ramayana was about a way of life. It is also about goodwill, love, and respect. The other day, we all celebrated the Bhumi Pujan for the restoration of Rama Temple. We should really think in terms of evaluating the great qualities of that great person. You may call him God, you may call him as an ideal person, ideal king, ideal son, and whatnot. But one must really, once you do Ramayana Parayana, that is not to worship Rama. It is to worship the qualities and practice them in our life. That was the purpose. Madam Lakshmi Sardiji is to highlight the contemporary relevance of India's age-old dharmic traditions in the modern world. That is very much required for our younger generation. Dear sisters and brothers and youngsters, you are all aware the new education policy was launched a few days ago. It's a visionary document that lays emphasis on holistic development of the students. Dr. Kasturi Rangan, the great son of this great country, he headed that committee. That document focuses on adopting interdisciplinary approach towards imparting knowledge and skill sets and in shaping the attitude of students. It's a learner-centric and aims at transforming India into a knowledge society. It rightfully balances the rootedness and the pride in India, as well as acceptance of the best ideas and practices in the world of learning from across the globe. I'm happy that the new policy gives importance to mother tongue in schools. This is very important to preserve and promote our rich Indian languages. I have time and again said there should be no imposition and no opposition to any language. Simple. No imposition, no opposition. That is the position. So the children must be provide an opportunity to learn as many languages as possible. But first of all, they should be taught in the mother tongue. School education aptly referred to by Mahatma Gandhi as the beautiful tree should focus on integral living, where education is both theoretical and practical. School students must also be taught the spirit of national idealism, where the nation comes first and everything else subordinate to national interest. There is a need for raising the standards of education and increasing the professional competence of teachers. Teachers must be friendly mentors and act as role models in their behavior and attitude. Education is not merely to get employment, and purpose of education has to be enlighten and empower an individual. Education must build character, caliber, capacity, besides promoting good conduct. While enhancing access to higher education, there is a need to considerably improve the quality of courses and teaching process. I'm happy to know that the new education policy also seeks to reduce the syllabus. There is a need to bring down the load on the students. Students should be made to spend equal time in playground and classrooms. I can share with young students, during my school days, half of the time in classroom, remaining the time in the other social, cultural, and sports activities. There used to be a craft class. There used to be a gardening class. There used to be a NCC, NSS, or Air Wing class. And also, these children used to be taken out to show important places. The idea is to educate them right from the beginning. Students must also be encouraged to place equal emphasis on physical activity and sports. Yoga should also form part of school education at an early early age, because we are all seeing now how the present generation is suffering because of lack of physical activity. We must go back to our old system of promoting physical activity. Yoga is an exercise of mind and body, two in one. And it's not costly. It is available everywhere. It should be promoted in all the schools. And yoga has no religion. Yoga, as I told you, is an art as well as science. There should be an understanding and appreciation of Indian art and cultural heritage. Of course, Padma Seshadri Pal Bhavan is known for promoting such activities. I'm happy that the new education policy has touched on these critical issues in school education. I'm very confident that the future of India is going to be shaped by holistic approach right from early school days. Schooling should not be unidimensional and one-sided. There should be cooperation and coordination between the teachers and the students. The students must be taught that nature is our first teacher and culture is a vehicle of refined expression. Nature, culture, together for better future. Students must know the uniqueness and historical background of every Indian state is also how Bharat Mata is supreme, embodiment of a nationalistic imagery. I would like to quote the great poet Subramanya Bharati, who in Enthoy stresses on the united spirit of Bharat Mata. Muppadu Kodi Mahamudayal, we are Mayambara Ondudayal, Ival Seppumali Padinettudayal, Enir Sindhanai Ondudayal. The beautiful poem that brings out the essential unity in diversity, which has been the foundational spirit of our great country, Bharat. Unfortunately, the COVID-19 pandemic impacted us in various ways. Normal academic schedule has been disrupted and many schools have taken to virtual education. This is, however, a temporary arrangement, as nobody can replace a true teacher and no virtual mechanism can give the flavor of real-time classroom learning. The teachers are the poets of Indian society. In the highest human traditions, teachers are personification of divinity. The management and the teachers, they must take education as a mission, should not give any remission or do any omission, and should consider this as a mission, not for any commission. This has to be understood by all. I am not saying this for Padma Seshadri students or teachers. This is universal for everybody. Education has to be a mission. That idealism has to be there in everybody's mind, whoever starts an education institution. You can't leave everything to government. Government alone cannot do everything. With a population of 130 crores, you need to rope in private sector, private initiatives, voluntary organizations, and those voluntary organizations who are interested in running education institutions, they should be guided by the spirit of nationalism, guided by the spirit of missionary spirit to convey better education to the children, because they are the future of our country. My dear youngsters, there are a lot of opportunities in India. India is on the move. This is a temporary setback to our momentum. But I am sure, going by the way reforms are being implemented, and the Prime Minister has given a three-line mantra of reform, perform, and also reform, perform. That's the guidance he has given to us. We have to perform the reform. The idea is that every individual has to perform his or her responsibility. It should not be left to only government or the Prime Minister or the Chief Minister. They will do whatever they can do. But all people, managements, teachers, and students, they have to perform their responsibilities. The idea of the call given by the Prime Minister is to motivate everybody to move in that direction. And also, the children must be taught to upgrade their skills, because at a young age, if you really impart them the needed skills, that they will be able to excel. We are seeing our students across the globe, they're all excelling. If you provide them an opportunity, they will excel. Many of the Indians, particularly even from Tamil Nadu, they're all occupying important positions in various countries, in various organizations. I need not give you examples. I don't want to take your time. There are many people across the globe, Indians, people from our country, and people from southern part and also from Tamil Nadu, who are excelling in various fields. So there are opportunities. Grab those opportunities. Take advantage of the institutions like Padma Seshadri, and then move on. I would like to conclude by quoting Saint poet Thiruvalluvar, who brilliantly summarized the purpose of education in his Thirukkural couplet, when he said, Karka Kasudara Karpavai Katripin Nirka Adurkutaha. Let a man learn thoroughly whatever he may learn, and let his conduct be worthy of his learning. I'm sure students passing out of Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan group will strive to laurels to this institution, be worthy members of the society through their actions and deeds. I'm also happy that the group of schools is conducting a national level annual quiz on this occasion, and also organizing a month-long cultural tribute to Mrs. Rajalakshmi Pardasarathi. I would like to advise you all concerned, call her in full name. That's a part of a tradition in certain parts, and also the English, this thing that you call somebody as a Mrs. So-and-so and all. That's okay. She's definitely a Mrs. But at the same time, Rajalakshmi Parasarathi is a name. So we should always use the full name. Not only for that, even for the institutions also, Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan. What is the difficulty? I don't understand. The shortcut introduced by Britishers. In every walk of life, Mahatma Gandhi Road, they call it as MG Road. What is MG? We don't know. We know, of course, in Tamil Nadu, MGR. But what is MG? See, and I saw in Secunderabad, SP Road. I said, SP is such a powerful, great man that a road is named after him. They said, no, sir, Sardar Patel Road. Sardar Patel Road has become SP Road. Mahatma Gandhi Road has become MG Road. Because of this sort of practice, I want this Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan to be called as Padma Seshadri Bal Bhavan. And also to pay tribute to Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parasarathi, let us call her by full name. That's only my suggestion, of course. And I don't want, even I told my people also, Mr. and Mrs. Venkaiah Naidu. I always tell them, there is a beautiful name for her. Use the name. Usha Naidu. So then they started nowadays using her name. Otherwise, the British practice of Mr. and Mrs. Venkaiah Naidu. I was not happy with that. These are all small things, but small is beautiful. And if you perform your duty, it will become dutiful. So please take this advice in right spirit. And also I suggest to the children also, whenever you talk about anybody, use their full name. I'm very happy that I have been given an opportunity to share my thoughts with you all today, this evening. I would have been much more happy to physically present, meet, greet our young children and teachers. But you know, the situation is beyond our control. The pandemic, I hope this pandemic will come to an end at the earliest and we'll be able to continue our regular life and then move on. Thank you very much. Nandri, Unakkam. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Mikka Mikka Nandri, Honorable Vice President. ஸ்ரீமதி ராஜலட்சுமி பார்த்தசாரதியை பற்றி பேசினதுக்கும் பத்மசேஷாத்ரி பாலபவனை பற்றி பேசினதுக்கும் நலந்தா யூனிவர்சிட்டியிலிருந்து ஆரம்பித்து மாடர்ன் டே எஜுகேஷனை பற்றி ரொம்ப அருமையாக பேசினதுக்கும் மிக்க மிக்க நன்றி. Thank you so much, sir. It is indeed an honor to listen to you. I'm sure every one of those words will be echoing in the ears of students for generations. So may I kindly invite Mr. P.B. Balaji, who is the president of the Parent Teacher Association, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. A very happy evening to one and all signed in to view and e-participate in this very memorable event. I am reminded of a quote of a very famous writer: feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. I deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this very momentous occasion. First and foremost, our salutations to the omnipresent Almighty, who has given us the power and the strength to go about this program so very smoothly. On behalf of the Padma Seshadri Balabhavan family, I am most grateful and thankful to His Excellency, the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, to have spent the time with us in spite of his very hectic schedule. I think, sir, your lecture should be reserved for posterity and played at every school. Each student and teacher across the globe should hear your Excellency's words today. Really golden words. I also thank Mrs. Sheila Rajendra, Dean and Director, for the very thought, first of all, for the very thought of organizing an event of this magnitude, especially during this very difficult times of COVID. And for the welcome address, which is very crisp and neat, couldn't have been better. Thank you, ma'am. I'm also duty bound to thank the Office of the Vice President of India for coordinating with us and the technical team very patiently. I must also thank the press and media for the very wide coverage they have given. Special thanks is also due to Mr. Radhakrishnan Srinivasan, the anchor, who has added great value to this evening's proceedings. As you all know, the COVID pandemic has definitely created a lot of difficult times for us, but there are good take-homes from the COVID pandemic also. For example, parents, teachers, and students from all over the globe are watching this event live. This could happen only because of the new normal. And I would be failing in my duty if I don't speak about the star of the event, Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathy. She was very fondly known as Mrs. YGP, but since His Excellency said I should refer to her full name, Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathy was definitely a superwoman, as Mr. Radhakrishnan Srinivasan mentioned earlier. And being a student under her, I can personally vouch for that. She was multi-talented and she has earned number of titles, Bhishma Pitama, Vidya Shakti, but to the Padma Seshadri Balabhavan family, she is immortal and will always be a living legend. I'm sure she will be with us, blessing us from wherever she is and guide us through the future endeavors of the school and the institution. Thank you once again to all of you. Thank you, President Sir, for the wonderful lecture. I think you have set very high standards was on the first lecture itself for the other speakers to emulate in the following years. Thank you once again. And please don't go away. Please stay tuned. We have wonderful events lined up for you. Mr. Radhakrishnan will take over from now.
Thank you so much, Mr. P.B. Balaji. Thank you so much, of course, to the Honorable Vice President. It was really gracious of him to have taken his time out of his busy schedule to be a part of this glorious occasion. Right, and as Mr. P.B. Balaji mentioned, there is loads in store. So where do we start? I don't even know where to start, to be honest, because as an alumnus of PSBB, I think what we are going to witness over the next half an hour or so is almost a jog down the memory lane. It takes me back in time to the 80s and the 90s when the General Assemblies, even before my time, and it was introduced. And I think I should thank the PSBB Group of Schools or the Padma Seshadri Balabhavan Group of Schools immensely, because to be honest, that really helped me find a career path for myself. To that extent, I think I'm immensely grateful for Padma Seshadri Balabhavan. Right then, for people who are tuned in, for a lot of those youngsters, there's plenty that is in the offing. For starters, in a few moments from now, we will be unveiling a national level quiz competition, so just hang in for that. And then there is a lovely book launch as well from one of our alumni, and I think he has spoken about the grit, the will, the determination of Dr. Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathy. And you talk about the grit and power of Dr. Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathy. She had that power, didn't she, to change the world around her and hence the world around us.
Shakti Kala Shaya Shakti Men may come and men may go, but PSBB will go on forever.
Thank you, of course, to Dr. Shobhana Vignesh, who is a Kalaimamani, Sri R.P. Shravan for the rendition, and of course, thank you, Sri Vivek Siva, for composing it. Before proceeding any further to witness some fine performances from the students of PSBB from different branches, let us pause to invoke blessings from the Almighty.
Adi Shakti Indra Vidya Shakti Ni Kriya Shakti Jnana Shakti Medha Shakti Adi Shakti Indra Vidya Shakti Ni Kriya Shakti Jnana Shakti Medha Shakti Parashakti Mahashakti Sakala Kala Shakti
ఆధార శక్తిని అద్భుత శక్తి పరాశక్తి మహాశక్తి సకల కళా శక్తి ఆసియం తాండిగ అద్భుత శక్తి.
Thank you so much to the three A's as I address them, Akash, Aravindachan, and others. Lovely, of course, to listen to you all beautifully, recited there. Right, let's move on, because when you think about Padmasri Shadri Balavan, there are a variety of things that come to your mind. You talk about the culture, you talk about the heritage, the Honorable Vice President was talking about those areas, but you talk about music, you talk about debates, you talk about quiz. We seem to have it all, not just today, but for the last 6 decades or so. And therefore, it is this variety that we are about to showcase over the course of the next half an hour. Talking of nurturing those young minds, I'm sure there are a lot of those young minds that are eager to understand what's in there for me. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. There you go, youngsters. A class apart, that is the national level quiz competition that is coming your way to all you quizzing enthusiasts. And I'm sure, Mr. Sheila Rajendra, this is a project that is very, very, very close to your heart, isn't it?
RK. Yes, thank you, RK. It is. With the grace of the Almighty and with divine blessings of Mrs. YGP, Rajalakshmi, Srimati Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi, on behalf of the Padma Seshadri Balabhavan Group of Schools, it's my proud privilege to officially launch, inaugurate the Class Apart Dr. Mrs. YGP Memorial Quiz. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So those who feel who are a class apart, go ahead and participate in a class apart. Even if you don't think you are a part of a class apart, you can still be a part of it and maybe feel a class apart. So go ahead and make sure that you register yourself. Just to give you a bit of a heads up, it's a national level inter-school quiz, and it is an annual event, by the way, and is open to students from grade 6 to 8. And if you're wondering who the quizmaster is, it is one of the finest in his field. It is Mr. Giri Balasubramaniam, and it is a venture that has been digitally supported by Tata Consultancy Services. So all you seasoned quizzers and all you freshers, fasten your seatbelts, because this promises to be really exciting. I'm sure you'll have a lot many questions out there, but just in case you want the answers to all those questions, the website is mentioned there. Just go ahead and figure out what your questions are and you'll find the answers to each and every one of those questions. Right then, let's move on, okay? When we think of Dr. Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi, when I say broadly, I mean every one of us who is a part of PSBB, a lot of us who have been fortunate to interact with her. I recall my days at PSBB when she always used to be that friend, philosopher, mentor. You can always knock on the doors of Dr. Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi and she will lend you that helping hand. And when you think about her, the first thing that comes to your mind is the infectious enthusiasm that she always presents. And there is never really a dull moment with her. And this thought, of course, is beautifully essayed in the book that is titled The Women of Our Lives. Just love these thoughts, of course, from the chairman and the managing director of the Indeco Leisure Hotels. And of course, a PSBB alumnus, Mr. Steve Borgia, batch of 1975. There's something fascinating about the 60s and the 70s, isn't it? They give you a sense of that history, a sense of where we really got everything from. And I think it's very pertinent for all of us to listen to it, to read every one of those chapters, because it will give you a whole new narrative. Because what we are seeing is the world that we live in, but it's always important to have that sense of history. And I think that is exactly what Mr. Steve Borgia has attempted to give through the eyes of Dr. Mrs. YG Parthasarathi. And of course, would definitely love to get my hands on the book as well to know her a lot better.
Oh,
the romance of those black and white photographs, just beautiful, captures the essence of the 60s and the 70s. I'll tell you what, that is of course the presentation of Mr. Steve Borgia, but there are a lot many of us actually, the minute we came to know that this event is happening, I can vouch for the fact that the WhatsApp groups that involved the boys from PSBB, the women from PSBB were absolutely buzzing. I'm sure a lot of students from yesteryears are watching this live on YouTube. And when we are talking about alumni, how can we not have their thoughts? We did reach out to a few of them, and here are a select set of alumni that are speaking to us about Srimati Rajalakshmi Parthasarathy. We, of course, have Dr. Vaidhi Subramaniam, who is the Vice Chancellor of Sastra University. But, of course, we start with Mr. Ravi Raghavendra, who is a fine personality, a theatre personality in his own right.
Greetings to all. Paying tribute to Mrs. YGP, or Rajamma as we all know her, is probably one of the easiest things one can do. Because any good trait that you want to refer to will apply to her. But on this momentous day, I just want to focus on one important trait of hers. She was a daring lady. A daring lady who dared to follow her passion, her vision, which became her mission. She started a school as early as in 1957, braving all odds with minimal resources, financial resources, people resources, and of course wherewithal. And she dared to combat the giants of those days and ultimately became a giant killer. Which way? She dared again to put out her first batch in 1968 of 5 students, second batch of 7 students in 1969, of which she produced a university first rank and thereby became a giant killer. And as the school grew from strength to strength to strength, she became a giant in her field herself. She focused on character. Careers followed. She inculcated values. The value of the school followed. She underscored quality and quantity followed. It is probably impossible today to get an admission in Padma Seshadri schools. And more importantly, she reiterated zest and spirit in life, which we all need to follow. If I should encapsulate Mrs. YGP, she was an entrepreneur, an educationist, a connoisseur of fine arts, a very supportive wife, a doting mother, and above all, a very satisfied soul. A very satisfied soul because for all her achievements, for all her yeoman service to the field of education, she could have got many more accolades, but she took everything in the stride and took everything with a smile, because innately, Mrs. YGP Rajamma was spiritual. Bye-bye.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good evening, friends. I consider it a very rare privilege to be a part of this evening's event in honor and as a tribute to the legendary educationist, Mrs. YGP. Mrs. YGP, who many of us know, was an institution builder and somebody who was responsible to shape the careers of many individuals, their lives and livelihoods. The institution that she founded in 1958, the Padma Seshadri Balabhavan group of schools, stand today amongst one of the tallest schools in the country. And not only was she responsible in building the PSBB as an institution, but also was equally responsible for changing the educational landscape of our country. More importantly, the school education landscape. Some of her visionaries' ideas were already in place. And some of them, we see them tellingly visible in the recently announced new education policy to prove the point that Mrs. YGP was far ahead of times in her thoughts and actions. As somebody who shaped the lives of many individuals, she was responsible for building the body, mind and soul of every student that left the portals of the institution. I consider it very fortunate to be molded by the best pair of hands in the school education landscape of our country. In the passing away of Mrs. YGP last year, her physical mortals would have left us, but her spirits continue to guide us, eternally etched in the institution's memory as well as in our own individual's memory. For the Kulaguru of the Gurukul called Padma Seshatri, sleep is short death and death is a long sleep that will awaken us with the spirit of building a very strong India. Namaskar.
Thank you so much, of course, to Mr. Ravi Raghavender and of course to Dr. Y.P. Subramanian. Go back a long way, batch of 1992. I was 3 years junior to him, so my super senior, Dr. Y.P. Subramanian. It's wonderful to meet you, of course, on this virtual platform. Right, let's move on from one generation to the next, or rather fast forward a few generations, because what you're about to witness right now will simply make you go, wow. Because going through during the rehearsals, I went, wow, this is some serious talent. I'm sure every one of you who's watched the performances of quite a few PSBDians in the recent past would know her. Her name is Janani Hariharan. She is in Standard 5. And this Kathakalachivam is just brilliant. And she captures the essence of Srimati Rajalakshmi Parthasarathi. The Sarathi, as in the charioteer of modern education with traditional values. Have a look.
I am honored to share a few words about our beloved YGP ma'am. Namba ipo sollin irukkaradhu ketind irukkaradhu idella enge irundho ketindu nammala bless pannindirpa. Vaacho vegam manasa krodha vegam jihva vegam udaro pasta vegam ये तान वेगान्यो विषहे कदीरः सर्वं अपि मां पृथुवीं स शिष्यात् इद स्वामी श्री प्रभुपादा गुरुव पत्ति एळुदिन ओरु श्लोकम ओरु गुरुनुडैय गुणंगळ एन्न अवर एप्पडि इरुवार अप्पडिंगरत पत्ति एवन ओरुवराल அவருடைய வாக்கினுடைய வேகத்தையும் மனசனுடைய வேகத்தையும் கோபத்தினுடைய செயல்களையும் ஐப்புலன்களுடைய தூண்டுதலையும் அடக்க முடியுமோ, எவர் ஒருவரால நிதான புத்தியோட செயல்பட முடியுமோ அவரே இந்த உலகம் முழுக்க சிஷ்யர்களை ஈர்க்க ஒரு குருவா இருக்கக்கூடிய தகுதி உடையவர் அப்படின்னு இந்த ஸ்லோகம் சொல்றது. இது நம்மளோட வைஜிபி மேனுக்கு ரொம்பவே பொருத்தமா இருக்கும். அவ பிறந்ததே ஒரு சுவாரஸ்யமான கதை. ஒரு சமயம் சென்னை எழும்பூர்ல ஒரு ஞாயிற்றுக்கிழமை அன்னைக்கு ஒரு ஹரிக்கத்தை நடந்துருந்தது. அதை கேட்க ஒரு அம்மா அங்க கர்ப்பஸ்ரீ பெண்மணி அங்க போயிருந்தா. கதையில உபன்யாசகர் கிருஷ்ண ஜனனத்தை பத்தி சொல்லியிருந்தாராம். மண்ணும் மலையும் கடலும் உலகேழும் உண்ணுக்கிரத்து மகிழ்ந்துண்ணும் பிள்ளைக்கு வண்ணமெழில் சொல் மகர குழைவை தின்னமிருந்தவா காணீரே செய்யிழையில் வந்து காணீரே அப்படிங்கிற ஆழ்வார் பாசுரம் அங்க ஒலிச்சிருந்தான். அப்போ அந்த கர்ப்பஸ்ரீக்கு வலி வந்து பக்கத்தாலேயே ஒரு ரொம்ப அழகான பெண் குழந்தை பிறந்துதான். அந்த குழந்தை வேறு யாரும் இல்ல, மகாலட்சுமி கடாட்சத்தோட மட்டும் இல்ல சரஸ்வதி கடாட்சத்தோடையும் பிறந்த நம்மளோட ராஜலட்சுமி மேம் தான். அங்கயோ கதையில உபன்யாசக கிருஷ்ண ஜனனம் நடந்தது. இங்கயோ இந்த கர்ப்பஸ்ரீ பெண்மணிக்கு ராஜலட்சுமி மேமுடைய ஜனனம் நடந்தது. அம்மாவுடைய அன்பிலும் அரவணைப்பிலும் கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சமா வளர்ந்து வந்தா கல்லூரி படிப்பையும் முடிக்கிறான். எப்படி கிருஷ்ணன் பார்த்தனுக்கு சாரதியா பார்த்த சாரதியா நின்று அர்ஜுனனை வழி நடத்தினானோ அதே போல நம்ம ராஜலட்சுமி மேமுக்கு சாரதியா திரு பார்த்த சாரதி அவர்கள் நின்று வழி நடத்தினான். அனந்த சயனம் மாமாவோட உதவியோட இவா ரெண்டு பேருக்கும் திருமணம் நடந்தது. அவர் கனவு கொடுத்த ஒரு ஊக்கத்தினால ஒரு சின்ன கூரை பள்ளி ஆரம்பிச்சானாம். மேலும் நிதி உதவியாலையும் அந்த ஊக்கத்தினாலையும் அந்த பள்ளி பாலபவனாவே மாறிடுச்சு. அந்த கூரை பள்ளி அது மேலும் உயர்ந்து 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 எக்கச்சக்க ஆயிரக்கணக்கான இளம் கலைஞர்களும் உருவாக்கித்தான். மேலும் அந்த பள்ளிக்கு நன்கொடை கொடுத்தவர் ஆர் எம் சேஷாத்ரின் ஒருத்தர், அவருடைய மனைவி பத்மா சேஷாத்ரி. அது ஞாபகமா கொண்டு பள்ளிக்கே பத்மா சேஷாத்ரி பாலபவன் வைக்கிறதுக்கு யாருக்கும் மனசு வரும். தன்னோட பெயரே கூட மிஸ்ஸஸ் ராஜலட்சுமிங்கிற தன்னோட பெயரை தன்னோட கணவர் பெயரோட சேர்த்து மிஸ்ஸஸ் வைஜி பார்த்தசாரதின் வச்சுட்டு மிஸ்ஸஸ் வைஜிபி மேமாகவே இறுதி வரைக்கும் வாழ்ந்தா. நம்ம கூட ஃபாண்டா மிஸ்ஸஸ் வைஜிபி மேம் தானே சொல்லுவோம். அப்படி வாழ்ந்திருக்கா. மேலும் அவளுடைய அயராத உழைப்புக்கு அங்கீகாரமா பல விருதுகளை பெற்றிருக்கா. முக்கியமா சொல்ல போனா 2010 இவாளுக்கு பத்மஸ்ரீ அவார்டே கிடைச்சிருக்கு. நம்ம எல்லாம் ஆளும் வேணும் பல்லுக்குருதி அப்படிங்கிற பழமொழிய கேள்விப்பட்டிருக்கோம். இங்க மானும் நூலும் வெற்றி குருதி அப்படிங்கிற புதிய ஆதிச்சூடிய அருளிய நம்ம பிஎஸ்பிபி ஔவை பிராட்டிக்கு நம்மளோட மனமார்ந்த நமஸ்காரங்களை தெரிவிச்சுக்கலாம். காலத்தை வென்ற பெண்ணாக என் கண்ணில் தோன்றுகிறாள். கடல் நிலம் நான் நேற்று வரை, விளை நிலம் நான் இன்று. என் கூரையின் கீழுதித்த ஒற்றை சூரியன் நீவே, உமை பற்றி பட்டம் என உயர்வோம் யான். உலக சாத்திரம் உம்மால் அறிந்தோம், சகல வித்தையும் கற்று தெளிந்தோம். சொந்தமில்லை வந்தமில்லை, எப்படி வந்தது இந்த பக்தி, எப்படி வந்தது இந்த பக்தி. அந்த பக்தியே நம்ம வைசிபி மேம்ட்டு தானே பயிர்கிறோம் கத்துக்கிறோம். இறுதியாக கல்வியாளர செதுக்கிற சிற்பியாகவும் குல குருவாகவும் தான் மிஸ்ஸஸ் வைசிபி மேம் நம்ம எல்லாரோட ஹிருதயத்திலையும் இன்னமும் பிரகாசிச்சிருக்கா. ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமஹ.
I'll be brutally honest with every one of you. I can't speak for everybody, but I can definitely speak for myself. I was just left wondering, left thinking what I was doing when I was in standard five. And I can assure you that I was doing absolutely nothing. The kind of confidence, the kind of poise, the kind of grace, the kind of pronunciation that this young kid, or the young superstar, I must say, has at this age is just unbelievable. Janani, I'm sure you're an absolute dynamite. You go girl is what I've got to say. Right then, let's move on from prose to discourses to a poem now, ladies and gentlemen. Verses from Anjali Bodempudi, I hope I've got the name right, and recited by Lalita Advita.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. This is a humble attempt at presenting an icon's life in verse. Presenting Sri.
Home is a treasure chest with theater, dance, and cultural fests. A little girl runs amidst this parade, picking up bits and pieces. And with this, an identity she'd go on to create. She's 16 years old now, already outsmarts the others. She's not too sure what the future holds for her. But don't be fooled. The uncertainty never scares her. She's 18 years old, the cusp of youth, the excitement of an evolution. A tryst with destiny and her letter to Gandhi. Her spirit of inquiry and the era of partition. It's 1947 and a journalist set out into the world. She's in her 20s now and a mother of two. We dread her as Rashmi in the Hindu, applauded her finesse in the Kumudam. But for her, another quest had opened itself. She's in her 30s and a teacher now. There is a two-roomed class on her terrace. Chalk-powdered knuckles stacked up textbooks. But she dreamt of other progressions now. She saw her teen spirit in a new age. She's 45 years old, an educationist now. 100 students face her during the morning assembly. Each one of them she'd mold passionately. Like a sand artist working his fine fingers, the intricacies are wondrous, indelible imprints. She's 60 years old, with a mighty empire to behold, strengthening her pillars faster and stronger, with PSBB shaping lives and Ramanuja blessing souls. An art critic, a lover of life, she taught us about these things no textbooks shall ever see. She's 90 years old now and younger than ever. Continued aspirations, understanding our generations, learning yet again from her students and their celebrations. Sometimes she remembers the simpler times when she'd perform on stages or play around with kids of all ages. There's still no show she'll miss. But for now, she is once again restless. A never-ending love for education. Her goals are endless. Another day begins in another city. As the pace of life waits for none, we'll remember her for this. That our lives are not measured in years, but are measured in the lives of people we touch around us. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Neatly edited there, I must say, by Rishabha Vijayarangan. Love the part where Lalita actually said, from one generation to another with a bit of a smile. And I can assure you that Dr. Mrs. YGP has met quite a few generations with tremendous amount of ease. And she's been a friend, a mentor, a philosopher, a guide, depending on what you sought her for. And of course, it wouldn't have been possible without a few remarkable qualities that made sure that she left an indelible imprint in the sands of time.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. The love that YGP ma'am had for her students is so huge, vast and immense. No words can describe that emotion of hers. So we attempted to describe it with action. We, the students of PSBB, put our humble effort to show how she dispels the darkness and leads the students to the light of knowledge and inspires them to dream big. Can there be anything else that we can ask for as students? Are we not blessed to come under her protective umbrella? Let's watch Indelible Imprints.
அகற்றும் இரவியின் கதிரும் நீ மானாக்கர் மனங்கவரும் நிறைமதி கதிரும் நீ நல்வழி நடத்திடும் நல்லக விளக்கும் நீ சாரதி பிரியே ரஷ்மி நீவாடியே பார்த்த சாரதி பிரியே ரஷ்மி Rashmini Vaadi.
A big thank you to you, ma'am, for passing on to us the invaluable gift of knowledge. The values that you have instilled in us will always lead us on the right path.
Youthful, gracious, and progressive in the background. That is what caught my eye, because she was ever youthful at heart. She was ever gracious in terms of encouraging students to strive for more. And of course, progressive. By practice, she was extremely progressive, wasn't she, Dr. Mrs. YGP? There's no way the institution could have attained the status that it has over the years, but for her thoughts. And of course, these were just a few manifestations. There are certainly more, as is explained by the students.
குருபியோ நமஹ. அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். தாமரை மேல் வீற்றிருப்பாள் லக்ஷ்மி, மலர் மகள் அலைமகள் மகாலட்சுமி. பத்மம் என்றால் தாமரை. பத்மாசேஷாதிரியில் வாழும் நீ மகாலட்சுமியே, நீ ராஜலட்சுமியே.
ஆங்கில கல்வியை நம் கலாச்சாரத்தில் கலந்து புதிய இந்திய கல்வி முறைக்கு வித்திட்டதால் நீ ஆதிலட்சுமியே.
13 பேருடன் தொடங்கிய பள்ளியை 1000 பேர் படிக்கும் பள்ளியாக்கினாய். தன்னம்பிக்கை, தைரியம், விடாமுயற்சி என உழைத்ததால் சந்தானம் நிறைந்த நீ சந்தான லட்சுமியே.
பறவையை போல் பறந்தாய், பல ஊர் பள்ளிகளை பார்வையிட்டாய், பார்த்ததில் சிறந்ததை தந்து முற்போக்கான நடைமுறையை வளர்த்தாய். மாணவ செல்வங்களின் அறிவு பசிக்கு தீனி போட்டதால் நீ தானிய லட்சுமியே.
கல்வியா வீரமா? உன்னிடம் பிடித்தது எது? உன்னிடம் உள்ள வீரமும் அந்த வீரம் பெற்று தந்த வெற்றியுமே.
காந்தி மகான் கேட்டதையா? எதிர்வினை எழுப்பிய உன் துணிச்சலையா? பாரத பிரதமருடன் அறப்போர் நடத்தி ஆண்கள் பள்ளிக்கு முதல்வரானதால் நீ தைரியலட்சுமியே.
நீ வீரலட்சுமியா அல்லது விஜயலட்சுமியா? பத்மஸ்ரீ விருது பெற்றதால் நீ கஜலட்சுமியே.
ஆதிலட்சுமி, சந்தானலட்சுமி, ராஜலட்சுமி என்றெல்லாம் உலகம் உன்னை அடையாளப்படுத்தினாலும் வித்தைகளை கற்பிப்பதால் நீ வித்யாலட்சுமியே.
உன் பள்ளியில் படித்த பிள்ளைகள் அனைவரும் பேர் புகழ் பெறுவதும் செழிப்புடன் வாழ்வதும் நீ தந்த கல்வியாலே. அவர்களின் அகப்புற செழிப்பிற்கு உத்தரவாதம் தரும் கல்வியை தருவதால் நீ தனலட்சுமியே.
ஒருபுறம் பார்த்தால் வித்யாலட்சுமி, மறுபுறம் பார்த்தால் வீரலட்சுமி, முகம் மட்டும் பார்த்தால் மகாலட்சுமி, உன் முகம் மட்டும் பார்த்தால் மகாலட்சுமி, முழுவதும் பார்த்தால் அஷ்டலட்சுமி, உன்னை முழுவதும் பார்த்தால் அஷ்டலட்சுமியே. ராஷ்மி என்கிற ராஜலட்சுமியே, உன்னை முழுவதும் பார்த்தால் அஷ்டலட்சுமியே.
Thank you so much, of course, to Niranjana, Apoorva Ramasesan, and VK Ram for putting together that wonderful, wonderful piece. Music, as is very, very evident, is very close to Dr. Mrs. YGP's heart. Especially that song, Krishnani Begane Baro, holds a very, very special place in her heart. And talk about music and talk about things that are very, very special. Here is Dr. Mrs. YGP in a rather special love that.
This song was very close to YGP ma'am's heart. Here is her version of the song, followed by a performance by the alumni.
Krishna, our version of Krishnani Vegani, we will be portraying the perspectives of three different women.
Namely, Yashoda, his mother, Radha, his lover, and Mirabai, his devotee.
Kalalandige ghejje nila
enthusiasm was very, very evident. A lovely work, of course, and I love the Abhinaya on the face of Dr. Mrs. YGP. Just that enthusiasm for life was so very evident out there. Right, ladies and gentlemen, what we've witnessed over the last half an hour or so is just the beginning of bigger things to come, because we're just about getting warmed up, as we say in cricket, isn't it? The first ball is yet to be bowled, and the final over or the final ball will be bowled on the 5th of September, quite rightly so, because we are indeed celebrating the Teacher's Day. And that, of course, is a big day as far as our lives are concerned, right? So this is just the start. And in fact, I've been getting quite a few WhatsApp messages as to how brilliant the performances have been, really, from the students from all the branches of Padma Seshadri Balabhavan have been. I said, look, it's no surprise, because we are meant to be excellent. And that is what has been inculcated in us time and time and time again by Dr. Mrs. YGP. So it just hats off to every one of you for having lived up to the level that is expected of us, right? When I said it is going to be a month-long celebration, there is plenty more that is due to come. In fact, on the 9th of this month, you can see Sarvesh, the Ashtavdani in action. He's, of course, an alumnus of Padma Seshadri Balabhavan, and the son of Ghatam Karthik. He's paid his special cultural tributes by creating a raga, incidentally, called Rashmi, and has composed lyrics in Sanskrit and played on instruments and digitized it as well. So make sure, of course, that you subscribe to this YouTube channel. I will have reliably learned through WhatsApp messages that close to about 2,000 people were watching just a while ago. So well done to all of you, students, and of course, the alumni of Padma Seshadri Balabhavan. And of course, as you know, Padma Seshadri Balabhavan is one huge family. I think just as each and every one of us students is connected to the institution, every one of those parents who've had their students go to PSBB have been very well connected to the institution as well. And I think the parents are putting together something extremely special to appreciate the kind of efforts that Dr. Mrs. Rajalakshmi Parthasarathy has put in to making this institution a grand, grand success. Thank you all, of course, for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed the show as much as we did in getting this across to you. And thank you, of course, to the Honorable Vice President of India, who was gracious enough to accept our invitation. Thank you so much to Mr. P.B. Balaji, the President of the Parent Teacher Association. Thanks so much for taking your time out. And of course, it would not be complete if I do not thank Mrs. Sheila Rajendra, the Dean and Director, and of course, correspondent of PSBD Group of Schools. It's only right, ma'am, that you've got to conclude what has been a phenomenal, phenomenal evening. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, R.K. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Many of us woke up this morning with a heavy heart and with mixed emotions. Same day last year, our dear Mrs. YGP left us. Sad that she was not physically not with us, and yet celebrating this day as her memorial day. Well, our young old grand lady, Mrs. YGP, and her life is a celebration indeed for the person who spread joy and lived life with great zeal, enjoying and appreciating every person and every little thing around her. Truly a legend. Thank you all for participating on this memorable occasion. We at Padma Seshadri Balabhavan Schools, Group of Schools, are grateful, and we are touched and moved by the love, affection, and rich tributes paid to our founder, Dr. Mrs. YGP. Please continue to watch starting from tomorrow at 6 p.m. every day, month long. Parents, distinguished personalities, present students, alumni, they all want to speak about Mrs. YGP and show their affection and love for Mrs. YGP. And there's going to be, every day, there's going to be some cultural offerings by our present students and by our alumni. Thank you once again. So we meet you again, perhaps on Teacher's Day, but you continue to watch on a daily basis our humble offerings from our students and others. Thank you. Good evening.